Hello dear viewer, ever wondered what the perfect distance for your perimeter wall is? Today we are going to find out. How many tiles should be between your defensive weapons and the incoming biter wave? This is a distance of 14 tiles, including the wall. And as you can see, the flamethrowers don't take any damage. But what if we change the distance? For biters it doesn't actually matter, because they are melee. They have to destroy the wall first, before they can do any damage to your weapons. But spitters have range. 13 for small, 14 for medium, 15 for big spitters and 16 for behemoth spitters. How does this range affect the perfect perimeter distance? Let's try again, this time with a distance of 13 tiles. Because the small spitters range is 13, they shouldn't be able to shoot over the wall. Again, no damage to the flamethrowers. I'm conducting the first experiments at evolution 0.35. At this evolution, spitter spawners will exclusively spawn small spitters. There will be more experiments at evolution factor 0.5, 0.7 and 1. This is a distance of 12 tiles. Spitters are now able to attack the flamethrower. That's 11 tiles of free space and 1 tile wall. Let's try again at a distance of 11. The flamethrower takes some damage again. This can be dangerous, because multiple enemy waves will eventually destroy this flamethrower. Evolution at 0.5 and distance 14. Only damage to the wall. But at distance 13, some spitters can shoot over the wall. Small spitters were not able to reach the weapon, but medium spitters do. A distance of 12 is obviously not sufficient at this point. And this all makes sense, because medium spitters have a range of 14. Distance 14, evolution 0.7. We are now facing big spitters. At least one spitter fired over the wall before it was broken. Reducing the wall distance, of course, doesn't help. Big and medium spitters have a higher range, so we take quite a lot of damage. But what if we choose a distance of 15? It doesn't come as a surprise. Big spitters can't reach the flamethrowers, because their range is 15. Let's ramp up evolution to get behemoth spitters. Well, this will be a total disaster. Keep in mind, the flamethrowers have no damage upgrades whatsoever, which is kind of remarkable. Flamethrowers are insanely strong, even without upgrades. Let's try again with refined flammables level 6. Behemoth spitters can fire over the wall, but we do survive this attack wave. So let's increase distance to 16. I didn't see any spitters firing over the wall until the first layer was broken. Any distance lower than 15 is obviously terrible for this stage of the game. Way too much spitter damage. Let's try 11, just for fun. That's no surprise, the distance is obviously not sufficient. Let's try a distance of 17. At this range, spitters can't fire even if the first layer of wall is broken. We survived and took no damage to the flamethrowers at all. Let's try a distance of 16 with a row of pesky wall spikes. This also works very well, but I'm still no fan of wall spikes and similar patterns. Let's try a distance of 16. This time with additional lasers that can only shoot at enemies already breaking through the wall. As you can see, this design works very well. You can of course build way more weapons to also prevent any wall damage. Walls are cheap and can easily be repaired or replaced. Based on the outcome of these experiments, I made 3 blueprints with a perfect perimeter wall distance. This one for the early game against small and medium spitters, an upgrade for later on when you face large spitters, and finally a late game design with a couple of lasers. When upgrading, you get a triple wall, but you can safely deconstruct the first layer. The blueprints are in the description below. Liking and subscribing is a great way to support the channel. Okay, thanks, bye.